Hello students, this is Savita Sharma. Welcome to our channel Brain Alive. In this video, we will study arrays. What are arrays? Arrays are the collection of same data type elements. They are stored and referred to by a single variable name. In arrays, each element of the array occupies consecutive memory location. Now, we want to store the marks of the students. Instead of declaring individual variable for each mark, we can store them in an array because it is easy to handle a single variable instead of many variables. So, marks can be stored in an array. This is a one-dimensional array represented by the row. These 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 and so on, these are the array indices. Means it shows the position of the array element. And 12, 13, 14, 80, and these are the numbers that are stored in the, these are the value of the array element. Marks is the name of the array. Zeroth element is called the first element of the array. And last, this is the last element of the array. Array elements are accessed by array name followed by the subscript. This is the array name marks. And in square brackets, 0 is the position of the element, means subscript of the element. The length of the array is because it is 0 to 14, so the length of the array is 15. Now we will study array declaration. How can we declare arrays? Arrays can be declared by typing data type, then name of the array, and then specifying the size of the array. This is the syntax of the declaration of array. First data type, then name of the array, then size of the array. Data type can be integer type, floating type, character type. These are the examples. Integer a square bracket, in square bracket this is 10, then semicolon. This shows the data type. It means a is an integer type array which has dimension 10. Next example, marks is an integer type array which has dimension 10. B is a floating type array which has dimension 20. And name is an character type array which has dimension 25. We can declare array by three ways. In first way, by specifying the size. In second way, by initializing the elements. And in third way, by specifying the size and by initializing the elements of the array. In first case, we mention the size of the array in square bracket. First, we will type data type, then array name, and in square bracket, the size of the array. Or in place of size of the array, we can use a variable name, which is initialized earlier. This is the example of this type. N is an integer type of variable initialized by 10. Then array 2 is integer type of variable having dimension 10 because n is 10, n is equal to 10. This is the first case. In second way, we can declare the array by initializing the element. In this case, we are not mentioning the size of the array. We are just initializing it by putting the value is curly brackets. 10, 20, 30 and 40. These are four values. It means it will automatically take the dimension of the array 4. The next case is by initializing and also specifying the size of the array. In this case, we mention the size as well as initialize by giving the values in curly brackets. This is integer type of array is integer type of array having dimension 6 and this array 1 is floating type of array having dimension 5. In this case, we will mention the values in floating type. Now, we will see the assignment of the array. This is the position of the elements. This is array 1. In first element, this will take the first element 24.5. This will be the first element, this will be the second, and this will be the third, and this will be the fourth, and this will be the fifth element. Means it is zeroth, then first, then second, then third, and then fourth element. This is the assignment of the array. Now we will see the types of arrays. There are two types of arrays, one dimensional array and multi dimensional array. In case of one dimensional array, it has only one subscript. This is the example of one dimensional array. Now in case of two dimensional array, there are two subscript. It has two or more subscript. This is the case of two dimensional array. This first square bracket shows the rows and second square bracket shows the column of the array. We can show this by a matrix. Suppose this is a matrix, this is a two dimensional array, this shows the rows and this shows the column. If we want to identify the individual element of the array, we can give the name of the array followed by the subscript, yani ki rows and column. Suppose we want to indicate this element of the array, we have to give the address of the array, rows and column, in which column and in which row it lies. For example, marks, array name, first row and first column, we have to give like this. Now how can we initialize the multi-dimensional array? We can initialize multi-dimensional arrays three ways, by giving in curly brackets, by giving the values of the array's element. The first one is, we are giving both number of rows and number of columns, and in curly brackets we are giving the values of the elements in a continuous manner. We are not separating by rows and columns by anything. In second case, we are giving elements by separating rows. This is the first row, then this is second row, and this is third row. Each row is separated by curly brackets and comma. In third case, we are initializing in this manner. The manner of initialization is same, by separating the number of rows in by curly brackets and commas. The difference is, we are not giving the number of rows. Actually, we can leave the leftmost dimension unfilled, others must be specified. So this is also one of the way, by leaving the leftmost dimension. The assignment of all the three cases will be this: rows 230 230 230 230. This is the first row, 159 159 159. This is the second row, and third row is 067 067 067. This is the third row. The assignment of all the ways will be same. So we can use any one method of the initialization. Now the question is, how can we access the array elements? Array elements can be accessed by giving array name followed by the subscript written inside the pair of square brackets. Let A is an array. Now we can use all these methods to access the elements of the array. The first one is A, means we are giving just name of the array. The means, if we are giving just name of the array, it means we are indicating the first element of the array. If we are giving in this manner name of the array and in square brackets position of the element, it means we are accessing that element, the position of which we have given in the square brackets. And we can also give in place of position of the elements a variable. We can also access the array by giving a variable, where we can change the value of this variable and access that particular element. We can also use value at address operator to access an array. This is also one of the method. And we can also use this method, in which we are using a value at address operator, and in brackets, in round brackets, name of the array plus variable of the position of the array element. This will be the same as AI, means name of the array and variable for the position of the element. This is also one of the method. I means position of the array element and name of the array in square bracket. This can be used to access every element of the array. We will understand accessing of arrays by using this simple example. दिस प्रोग्राम कंटेन्स टू डायरेक्टरीज stdio.h एंड conio.h. दीज डायरेक्टरीज आर इंक्लूडेड बिकॉज दीज डायरेक्टरीज कंटेन्स फंक्शंस प्रिंट एप एंड गेट सी एच. द मेन प्रोग्राम स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द वर्ड मेन. दिस इज द मेन प्रोग्राम. दिस मेन प्रोग्राम एरे ए इज इनिशलाइज्ड बाई दीज वैल्यूज इन कर्ली ब्रैकेट्स एंड इन दिस प्रोग्राम अ वेरिएबल आई इज ऑल्सो डिक्लेयर्ड फॉर यूजिंग इन लूप. वी आर यूजिंग फोर लूप इन दिस प्रोग्राम. आई इज इनिशलाइज बाई जीरो. दिस इज द कंडीशन एंड दिस इज द इंक्रीमेंट ऑपरेटर. इन फर्स्ट वैन द लूप स्टार्ट्स इट विल प्रिंट द फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट. वी ऑल्सो सी द आउटपुट हेयर. स्लैश एन इज यूज टू प्रिंट इन द नेक्स्ट लाइन. एलिमेंट एट ए परसेंट डी इज परसेंट डी परसेंट डी परसेंट डी एंड परसेंट डी एंड दीज आर द वेरिएबल्स. दिस आई इज फॉर दिस परसेंट डी एंड दिस इज फॉर दिस परसेंट डी एंड दिस इज फॉर दिस एंड दिस इज फॉर दिस वन एंड दिस इज फॉर दिस वन. नाउ वी विल सी द एड आउटपुट. When the loop starts, the value of I is 0. So, value at A, I value of I is 0. So, A 0 is now AI. Value at this address. This is 1. The first element is 1. Then this one. Value at this A plus 0 means value at A means it is indicating the first element of the array. So it is also 1. It is also indicating the first element 0 plus A. So it is also 1. And it is also 1. First element of A. So all these will be first element. So we can give any one of the three, any one of the four methods to access the elements of the array. In now the value of I will be 1. So it will goes to the second element of the array. A element at A 1. First element, this is the first element. This is the zeroth element and this is the first element means 2. Now the value is 2. This is printed by this one and this one. This is by this one. And this is by this one and this is by this one. So in this way we can access the value elements of the arrays by using these methods. Hope you liked the video. Hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos. Thanks for watching the video.